In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear friends in Christ, in today's reflection, I will talk about the miracles of Saint Joseph. Saint Joseph was the foster father of Jesus. He was a very gentle man. He was a very holy man. He was a very caring man who took care of Jesus and Mary. He was a man of few words, but yet filled with action and love. I've already discussed about Saint Joseph in one of my videos. I just want to share his miracle in this video. So, when I was posted to Atlanta, Georgia, so I was looking for a post of school guidance counselor. I went to one of the schools there and I met the principal and I discussed everything with the principal. So, and I told the principal how I really want to have this job. And the principal said, well, I would have loved you to have this job, but we have school guidance counselor right now, and the school guidance counselor is doing a very good job. I don't want to really let her go. And she's doing a very good job here. She's really amazing. I would have loved to have you here, but unfortunately, she cannot go. I cannot just let her go just like that. And I told her that I understand. And I went home, I continued my novena to St. Joseph. I was very confident. You know, in prayer, it's really very important that we have that faith. Because without faith, it will not have any effect. Or even if it does, we'll have very minimal. It is very important that we trust in God. It is very important that we believe in what we're saying when we're saying those prayers. We claim it. So I wasn't really disturbed. I wasn't really discouraged. It must not be that one. It must be something else. But all I know was that I continued my novena to St. Joseph. I was saying other prayers, but I was doing novena to St. Joseph. So a few days later, the principal wrote an email to me saying, hi, sister, please come and apply for the post of the school guidance counselor. Our school guidance counselor will be moving immediately with her family to another state. It's really very urgent, sister. Come and apply. Few days later, I said, I was like, wow, this Saint Joseph is really a man of action. Trust me, he's a man of action. He didn't even waste time. He created another job for the family. Very lucrative job that made the family to move, to create that space for me. Isn't Saint Joseph amazing? He is really amazing. Okay. One day, I entered the church. I was gazing at a statue. I was gazing at that statue. And a lady came, walked up to me and said, hey, sister, I can see where you are looking at that statue. Do you know who that is? He is Saint Joseph. Sister, he did a wonderful miracle for me. I was like, I'm so eager to hear that. He did a miracle for me too. I would like to hear your own miracle. So she said, I think she said it was a tumor. This has been, she's been suffering from this terrible sickness for a long time. And she's gone to virtually everywhere, gone to doctors, did everything, have taken a lot of medications and all that, but nothing. It was still very ill and it was so painful. Then one day, she just walked up to St. Joseph, touched his statue and told him, I said, hey, St. Joseph, please help me. I really want to be healed. I really want to be, you know, be able to do my daily work. I want to come to church. I want to do this. I can be able to do this. I can be able to do my work. I want to be well again. St. Joseph, please. Every other person failed. But I believe that you can intercede for me. I believe you can do this for me. The lady said that after that prayer, she left. My dear friends, that was it. She was completely healed. Just to make sure, she went to the hospital to check. And the doctor was amazed. The doctor looked at her and said, what happened? What happened? The doctor was surprised. Are you surprised? How can you be surprised at a man who carried God in his hands? A man who nurtured, a man who took care of Jesus. And look him in the eye and say, hey, boy, can you pick up this for me? Or can you do this for me? Send him on an errand. A man that taught Jesus how to be a carpenter. A man that nurtured him, carried him around, played with him. Why are you surprised? God can grant his prayers. The same way our blessed mother is so precious to God, the same way Saint Joseph is so precious. Even though he does not talk much, but he does a lot. I encourage you, my dear friend, to go up to Saint Joseph. If you have not studied the novena, start the novena to St. Joseph. You can Google it online, a lot of novenas. There are some of them in Peter's booklet. Make him your friend. Go to St. Joseph. He is truly amazing. I can go on and on to narrate a lot of miracles of St. Joseph, but I just want to say only these two. But I want to encourage you, stay tuned, because I am on a mission of bringing out miracles, telling about how God does a lot of miracles in our lives through the saints. Saint Joseph, or many other ways. It must not be a saint. It can be anything, an object. It can use anything to heal us, to make us come close to him. So my dear friends, let us turn to St. Joseph. He's so gentle. Look at his picture. So loving. Look at the way he took care of Jesus. He will take care of you. All your worries will be taken care of because he will pray for you. He will intercede for you. He will present all your intentions before the throne of God. God is truly amazing. He's so merciful. That was why he said in Jeremiah 29:11, I have plans for you. Plans to prosper you. Good plans. So even if you're going through a lot of troubles, a lot of difficulties in life, know that God has a future for you, a plan for you. He loves you so much. He just wants you to come close to him. He just wants you. So forget about your worries and allow him to take up those worries for you. Allow him to take care of you. We hold on all the time. Hold on. Hold on. Mm-hmm. We cannot even do it. We are so helpless without God. Let us just allow him. Let us come close to St. Joseph. Try this man. He will never fail you. So, as we celebrate the Feast of St. Joseph on the 19th, it was this 2023 is on a Sunday. So we'll still celebrate him, especially on Monday. But we kept celebrating him. Do not wait for 19th. Celebrate him every day. Celebrate him and our Blessed Mother Mary. They will never disappoint you. Let us turn to God. Let us approach him. The book of Mark, chapter 1, verse 15, he said, "The kingdom of God is here, is near." Let us turn to God. Let us repent and turn to God, especially this Lenten season. In our Lenten journey, God is so beautiful. God is so sweet. So even if you're going through suffering, do not say, "Hey, God has abandoned you." No, he did not. That was the desire of the devil, to make you feel that God abandoned you. He can never forsake his own. He can never lie. He might not be going very well right now, but it shall be well with you. Just trust in God. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Our Blessed Mother Mary, pray for us. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, have mercy on us. Bless us and our families, our relations and our friends. May God bless you and your family. Amen.